The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour. Doesn't matter where you're at, as long as you're here at this time. I knew it was going to happen. I knew it. Let's do this. Let's fix it again. This seems like an ongoing battle. When you plug stuff into USB ports, but I do digress.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
So what do we have? Well, certainly have market went a lot farther lower than I thought yesterday. Went a lot higher today. The difference is we were down on about twice the volume that we're up. Looks like 12, 13 billion shares yesterday. And for today so far, we're doing about 6.3, 6.4 billion shares. So a very light pop back up. And as we've been talking about it over the last week and watching it develop, you want a sharp for that double repo pattern. You want that sharp, sharp move lower. And then you get a handful of days where it goes back through the 3x3 or displaced moving average a little higher. And then the next close underneath that's the one you want to sell. We saw it work in NVIDIA. We've got a lot of them set up there. Now, generally you get a handful of days below and then a couple of days above, and then it turns south. But in NVIDIA, you had one day up, one day down, one day up. Well, actually, you had a bunch of days up, one day down, one day up, and then it turned. And I'm wondering if that isn't setting the pattern to a very manic, depressive market. What I can say is that the rumors of a giant short squeeze are probably not true. Almost nobody was shorting the downside. Almost nobody shorted the downside on Friday or Thursday. Short or bears are far and few between, but what is apparent over Friday and yesterday is that there's nobody willing to short this market to any extent. 2 weeks ago on a Friday, we had the lowest short sale numbers in 20 years. So the bears haven't come back. We did have kind of a nice pull back lower. Certainly, you would have seen some decent volume on the upside here if there would have been a lot of shorts getting squeezed out today. Now, you could make a case that they're just sitting on their hands and going to let this play out. But I don't think so. That would be very different than the rest that we've had. So what are we going to do today? Well, we're going to look at stocks and see whether or not this thing can stick higher. We still don't have the confirmation of the double repo patterns that I've been talking about for a while. But we'll go through some of those ballistic stocks that we were looking at before and kind of look and see what we want to act on when it happens, but not bet on before it does. Okay, what else do we have going on out here? Dow's up 600 points, NASDAQ's up to 245, Russell's up 61. And, of course, Apple's up about $4, but about 60 million shares. So we'll look at some of the leaders out here. Why don't we do a little history, and then we'll move on in the next segment for all the stocks.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
And what do we have here? A few shorts to be found. Of course, we talked about that. Options rollover, which is the last day today. My guess is that we'll probably have, if I am right about the double repo pattern setting up, we'll probably have some indication of that by tomorrow afternoon. As far as histoire, on this day in 1969, the Eagle, the U.S., the Apollo 11 lunar module successfully lands in the area of the moon known as the Sea of Tranquility. Upon landing, Neil Armstrong utters the now famous phrase, "The Eagle has landed." About 6 hours later, while setting foot on the moon, he utters probably the most famous phrase ever. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. And of course, unrelated news. Dr. Evil, the ex-head of Amazon, the ex-CEO, went to outer space. On the downside, he did return. But he's getting skewered and probably well justified, mostly because of the shape of his rocket, but also kind of grandstanding after the event, which was kind of like spiking the ball. You're a billionaire. You go up on a rocket. You don't have to act like a jackass. But that's just me. And, of course, he does look kind of like Dr. Evil. A lot of those memes going around today. Two questions. First is, what about put buying surge? No, there wasn't a put buying surge by any level. And generally, every decent low has had a bunch of people pile on. I've always talked about a market hitting decent highs when the shorts can no longer pull the trigger. Well, certainly we didn't get a lot of people buying puts or equity, although it went up slightly. It's never broken 50-50. And for years, it was always heavy put buy. So maybe they're buying the ES and selling it short. You can make an argument that way, but generally, there should be some kind of normalized run rate for those things, and there just isn't. So victory laps for everybody. Branson's flight was much cooler. Nay. At least the one today got past the Kármán line, which is the defined line for outer space. Branson didn't even make it there, but it was kind of cool to watch him fly back in. But you know what? Back when we had what were they called in the 20s, where everybody acted just horribly to everyone that was incredibly rich? The Gilded Age. It's just the Gilded Age, but instead of building big mansions on Rhode Island and building big boats, they're now all having to fight over going into space. But I think it's going to, 10 minutes and it's over. Doesn't seem like it. We'll be back in a minute. We'll start looking at some of these other stuff. Got some more emails. Call me at 877-927-6648.
Are you grinding in the market, but seeing little to no return? Or are you a successful trader, simply looking to make your job a little easier? Learn to take the path of least resistance with David White's powerful trading newsletter. David White is an accomplished trader whose deep understanding of technology and the markets allows him to consistently find and share winning trades. Support and resistance define the ranges in which stocks trade. By understanding these trading ranges, David White is able to find the path of least resistance. David White's trading newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, is delivered daily before the markets open to make every trading day an easy win. Visit TFNN.com today and subscribe to David White's Ultimate Trading Newsletter for $119 a month. And try all of our newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Take the path of least resistance at TFNN, educating investors.
Thank you. What's separating you from the most successful men and women on Wall Street? That's right, information. Having all the information gives us the perspective we need to place the right trades at the right time. The TASS Profile Scanner is the premier market profile-based scanner. Powered by its acclaimed TASS proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner instantly filters over 2,500-plus global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodities, futures, and Forex. This powerful suite of tools leverages instant trade filtering and strategy formulation to show you emerging trades before they happen. For a limited time, you can save $100 off your first month by using the promo code UPGRADE, and you still get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Level the playing field with the TASS Profile Scanner, which you can find under the Services tab at TFNN.com. Sign up today.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And a question from Hector, who had a request yesterday that I didn't get to, mostly about how negative everybody was yesterday. So, Hector, I'm going to bring it to you today.
Why don't you knock it off with them negative waves? Why don't you dig how beautiful it is out here? Why don't you say something righteous and hopeful for a change? Always with the negative waves.
Yes, yes, yes. It was negative Monday, positive Tuesday. What a day a difference makes. Question from Hector is, how do you see the fund buying playing out this month? And, of course, it really isn't this month. The way that the dates fall, you're probably looking at August 2nd before any money comes in. So this being the 20th all day long and a Tuesday also all day long, we've got 3 more days this week and 5 more next week. So you got 8 days before you got fund buying. It's going to be kind of tough. My guess, as I said, is a couple things. I don't know how to handicap evictions and repossessions going forward, and that's already been settled by the Supreme Court. I don't think that there's anything going on that will allow them more than a day before it gets kicked back out. The courts have made it plain that if you want to do something, you're going to have to pass a law in Congress to do it, i.e., you'll have to actually do it the way that the Constitution says. And you can't just wave a magic wand at the CDC saying you can and cannot do stuff. So we at least have that from them. So I'm going to say it's high that it happens. I just can't right now tell how to handicap what's going to happen on the 1st of August when you will be able to start evicting people. If you're a landlord and you've been paying on something and getting absolutely nothing back, I understand that position. Also, that was done not to throw thousands of people out on the street in a single day or a week or a month. Those times have passed. We've given a lot of money away. Hopefully, if you haven't been paying, you've been saving up to go somewhere else. But that's probably too much to hope for. But if anybody's got any kind of idea on what's going to happen with evictions and or repossessions for people, you know, if you were in the restaurant business, I don't know how you made it through, especially if you had a good restaurant making lots of money. Suddenly you weren't. Those checks probably not going to go too far from the government. So are those people, have they renegotiated loans? I can't really find out a whole lot about it. Anybody has a viewpoint on that, give me a call, 877-927-6648. But I'm thinking that that's kind of what the market is winding up for. Maybe there are other programs that are coming out, but doesn't look like much action in the Congress right now. Okay, anything else? Now we're up 72 points. Again, not a lot of volume. We are getting those. Let's go back to the usual suspects real quick and see how they're doing. As I said, this double repo pattern, when it works great. And you saw what happened with NVIDIA, which we'll look at next. You got the snap below on Apple. You've been above it since the 4th of June. And you've got what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24 days. Pretty much straight up. You gapped down yesterday. You still are not above the 3x3. Today, that would be 147.76. Tomorrow, it'd be 148.01. But what I suspect is if you just go sideways out here, that's real. The real power of the 3x3, you already know the numbers today. And that is if it's above 145.77 on the 22nd, that gets your close above it. So 140, let's say it just goes sideways for a couple of days, you're going to be above it. And then the next move down below it is when you start seeing a lot more like you had yesterday. Now, not a prediction. I am fairly bearish out here, but if it does that, just like NVIDIA, you want to hang on to your hats, NVDA, because these things work about 80% of the time. NVDA, if you can type correctly, and you see it. Now, this one was very tight, didn't last very long. The question is this going to be kind of the same thing as the market, or are we going to get a couple of days sideways after this big pop today? And again, it'd be different if I saw a lot of volume, but almost at the bottom of the hour here, doing about 6.6 billion shares, which is not a great deal. I am not going to pull the trigger, though, until I get some confirmation. Good trader reacts. He doesn't prognosticate ad nauseum, although I'm just showing the patterns in case they show up just like they did in NVIDIA. Now, we got a whole lot of nothing today in NVIDIA, but certainly not the kind of pop that you would think. But we'll see. To see what else do we have out here? We looked at NVIDIA. I wanted to look at the other ones. Microsoft, same kind of thing. You had the pop down below after being above it for forever. What is it going back here? Okay, you've been above it since the 6th of June, right? Yeah, 6th of June. You closed below it for the first time yesterday. You're pushing back up. Same kind of thing. This thing can just kind of hang around for 280, maybe even go up a little bit, 282, and then pull back below it. We're going to have almost all of these big stocks looking kind of the same. What else do we have here? I get to the rest of it. Another question about Bed Bath and Below, BBBY. Take a quick look at that. If I can move this thing around here a little bit. Where's my... there it is. Let's take a quick look and see what people have been doing in Bed Bath and Below. You don't have a lot of shorts in it. You've had 4 days since it went above 20% on a single day. That was on the 13th. You've had some days out here. Bi-monthly, that came down from 20 days to cover into the last reporting period of 1.7 days to cover. So seeing a huge, actually it was 10 days to cover, excuse me, back on the first of the year. So, you know, these guys running these big stocks, like I said, there isn't a lot here to jump up and down about when people talking about heavy shorting. It, as far as I can tell, doesn't exist. We'll finish up with Bed Bath and Below when we come back, but I don't see the same kind of juice that made it run twice back. There aren't the shorts in it. We'll be back in a minute.
Are you having fun trading the markets, but having trouble finding like-minded individuals to discuss your trading and investment ideas with? Become an apex predator in the trading markets and join the Tiger's Den Trading Room only at TFNN.com. The Tiger's Den is an exclusive trading room where successful traders from around the world come to exchange trades and ideas. Join the Den and surround yourself with the sharpest minds in the trading world. Subscribers to the Tiger's Den are also the first to have their questions answered live on air and can privately chat with our TFNN hosts live during their shows. Interact with other Tigers and Tigresses as they share trading ideas, news analysis, and discuss the market action all trading day. Subscribe to the Tiger's Den risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee and become part of the TFNN trading community. TFNN, educating investors.
You could be making money off the stock market, and if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den Trading Room, trading software, and educational webinars. Webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And a good question in the den, and that is, if you're thinking, looking at the spies here, what would happen that we went and started to down below on Friday and closed below? Would that satisfy it? And it would for just a general failure. But the big thing generally on double repo patterns, and you really don't have that big a one in the spy, if it went back, you can kind of see that about 425, which is kind of where we got to yesterday, was right where it went to. And that's why I'm saying that generally what I'm looking at is not so much the biggest indexes, but I'm thinking that a lot of these stocks that had been in this ballistic move are the ones where you're going to find some big movement. Where is that at? Scans. There they are. Apple. We'll just go through them here. Apple, you can see much clearly, more clearly on this one. They had a lot bigger moves because the SPYs, you know, as we said in the summation indexes, 80% of the market was being driven by 20% of the stocks or less, maybe 10%. So there wasn't a lot. But when we saw ballistic stocks like Apple, you go back to, what, the 14th of June, before this thing, you know, was actually popped above the 3x3 and never got back below it. ACN, kind of the same thing, although you're above it today. But that would take you back to 290, 285-ish, 290 on a failure on that one. That's why I'm saying that I kind of like this this pattern a little bit better. The indexes will come back, but probably not as sharp as some of these stocks. Adobe, you got one close underneath it. So you still need a little bit more work on that one to do something. Broadridge Financial, this one had a close underneath it. It's back above today. That's why I'm wondering if tomorrow afternoon, or I think either tomorrow afternoon or Friday, we're probably going to see that a lot of these, if they're going to make this pattern, we'll do it tomorrow afternoon or we'll do it on Friday afternoon. Costco never pulled back underneath it. Charles Rivers Laboratories, just kind of hanging up here. In fact, I'll turn this off so you can see it a little bit better. You did get a close underneath it. You're right back above it, but you really didn't get anything like a lot of volume on that one. Dollar General, this one didn't even pull back at all. Domino's looks a lot more like you get the same thing. Now, the Domino's patterns out here on a failure would bring you back to about 425. So especially if you can get some puts and you start seeing weakness, this pops back above, we'll say like 480 tomorrow or something, and then starts fading the rest of the day or fades by Friday, that sets up these much bigger patterns that I like. That would be, 420 on Domino's if this pattern develops. Garmin had one day underneath it. 143-ish, 142-ish is what this one would be. Now, you had your day underneath it. You're back above it. Now, the next, if you really think this is going south, actually a fairly decent company that I wrote off a lot of years ago, one that I was wrong on, just really didn't see how well they were doing in aviation and marine boating to actually get out of the handheld GPS market and actually move into something that makes massive amounts of money. But now they're 10 or 20 grand in the dash of every airplane you almost see. They've got other stuff, but I think that Garmin watch is probably 1% of the money they make. But, 10, 20 grand in a dash of a small airplane or even the larger ones, that is some sweet cash. Big sales, not a lot of support because it's, you got 20 grand out for one product, right? You get all the repair business on it, especially if it's the FAA. That's well worked out by people that are approved to actually work on this stuff. It's a pretty sweet business. And, of course, private area aviation and even corporate aviation has done well over the last year. Trimble's another one in that space, too. Humana, you got just a little taste of it yesterday, but not a real good close underneath it. But if this would develop, you got back to 420 on it, but it's not one of the ones. Iveric, IC is the symbol on this one. This is the one you want. This is kind of the one you want to watch. You got your first day underneath it, really on light volume. You get another pop back up, and then the next one back. This could go back down to $7. I'm not shorting a $9.50 stock, but the pattern looks good. That's what you're looking for. You just need more confirmation on it. Intuitive Surgical. This is another one that is setting up sweetly. This is what I like. You get a close underneath it. You push hard down. We had 702,000 shares yesterday, up on 428,000 shares today. So maybe you get 600,000. Next move underneath this thing, now it's at close to $1,000. So maybe it goes up and hits 1,000 first. But it's been running since 860. I think it could easily turn on you. Another one that looks really good is U.S. Growth ETF. That's IUSG. You got the close below. You got one gap down. You're pushing back higher. You need a couple more days above the 3x3 and then the next pull back lower. And just so you know, if you don't have a 3x3, you go to a 9-day, it's pretty close. It's that pattern you're looking for. I think a lot of people say that it's actually got to be exactly that. It's not. It's that move to the top that has a ballistic move to it. Couple days below, couple days above, the next move down, and you start getting volume. That's when these things fall apart. Anyway, I just like it because I kind of know on the right-hand side with the 3x3 what I'm looking for. So we get this thing above it. Let's say tomorrow, IUSG, U.S. Core Growth. You know, you get a couple of days in the 103s. The next close under 102.44 in the next couple of days signals that the top is in on that. IVW, which is the S&P growth, pretty much the same thing. And these, of course, growth stocks. But you need one pop above that line. And the, like I said, the good question was before, what happens if you don't get that? Then it's just a run-of-the-mill failure. The thing that this really does is tell you, you go back to where the whole thing started, because generally when these fails, that's exactly what they want to do. So yeah, maybe you get a couple bucks out of this if it's a regular failure, but if it is a double repo pattern, 80% of the time, you're probably coming back to $70, maybe even $69.50. So that's why these things are so so powerful when they do work. Don't get too far ahead of yourself. We'll be back in a minute.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at TFNN.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
And I was playing around with stuff, and I should know to do that. There we go. I should know better to do that. That's the way the cookie crumbles. Repeat. In the far left-hand corner of the United States, asks about the Cheesecake Factory. My experience out here in restaurants are half open with terrible food and service because they can't find people who will work. Also being hit with higher labor and food costs. Earnings debacle for the group coming? Don't know, but it doesn't look good. And like you said, a lot of things going against them. I think that a lot of people are not used to bad service. And I got to say that if you're down here in Tampa and you go to any of the places on the beach, they cater to tourists, and, you know, they force a 20% gratuity fee on you and other things because these guys are tourists. They're not coming back. Some of them from Europe, and they don't tip at all over there. So there's a lot of stuff going on, but I kind of always said it's service with a scowl, so I don't tend to go out to those places. There are some places like that that cater to the locals, but generally they're not down there in the most expensive part of Clearwater Beach. But yes, there's a problem with that if you can't get away with it, like the people in vacation spots. It doesn't look good. You did have a bounce today. You had higher volume yesterday. I don't know. Yeah, it's tough. What do we have here? Let me see. Okay, I've got Wednesday, July 28th for the earnings date for the Cheesecake Factory at 4:15, which means after the trading day if you live in Lutz. Just kind of a dead cat bounce here. There was a guy, I don't know if he's still around at all. His name was Bob Carver, and I always remember his name because there was a great engineer who designed amplifiers, Carver amplifiers, and I had a couple of them, and I actually met the guy a lifetime ago. The exact same name, Bob Carver. A wonderful pattern out here. Anyway, he had a pattern that he called kind of a contact lens. It's kind of just a big kind of flat domey looking top, which is exactly what this is. And that's never a good thing, as he would see it. You don't see that many of them. I don't know if he's around. Nice enough guy. Kind of big into the conspiracy theory part, I think, if I remember right. Been a long time since I talked to him, maybe 10 years. Interesting dude, but that he did, you know, if you talk to everybody, everybody's going to have at least one idea that's probably worth something if they've been in this business at any length of that forever. I mean, at least 5 years. They'll probably come up with something that they spotted that someone else hasn't. But this dome or contact lens thing, generally not good. Then you get into a lot of destructions back on the other side. I do see what you're talking about. My bigger fear would be that they get into, especially in areas of the country, shutdown 2.0, because we haven't learned anything in the last year. Last year, we didn't know. We should be smarter this year, but it doesn't look like we're going to be. So what can you say? I think it's read the headlines. If we get a lot of particular states shutting down and other ones like Florida, which I think you'd have to come around and run a stake through the heart of everybody here to go through that yet again. But it does vary across the country about what people are willing to give up and for what. Around here, not happening much, so I don't hear a lot about it. But if you're probably on the West Coast, maybe in the Northeast, maybe in Chicago, maybe those are the places where it would happen the most, is going to have at least a partial effect on companies that are in retail food, probably. Question is, did they make more money by not having waitresses and paying all those folks and just having delivery, which a lot of people believe they did, and that they would be better off just serving food and not having to actually wait on folks. But that is it. Phase linear. I had one of those. I wish I would have kept that amplifier. Man, that was a sweet amplifier. That and Macintosh's. That was the Bob Carver phase linear was before he went on his own. But he had to, he worked for phase linear. What a sweet amplifier. Ghost kitchen concept popping up everywhere. I'm not much on ghosts. Anyway, interesting idea. Again, you got plenty of time. If anybody has any idea in the real estate business outside of Florida, where we're not going to probably have a problem, let me know if there is going to be an issue by the end of this month, or at least your views on it. I'd be very interested to hear it. 877-927-6648. Other stocks out here that we want to go look at. Lithium. Now, this one would be a fairly nice double repo pattern. What you need is one more close above it. The biggest thing is this thing's very gappy, LIT, but you get another one back above it, and you could see a move back from about what would probably be about 77, 78 on a failure, go back to 70. And this one, maybe it's got some decent cheap puts on it. I actually went to look at puts for August 20th on something today on a $30 stock, and they're $6. What does that tell you about what people are thinking on at least some of these stocks out here? I'll probably actually have to take the equity because I'm not paying $6 for a $10 move. That tells you that they're really thinking that there is problems right here in River City. Okay, what else do we have out here? Nothing on MSCI yet. Microsoft, we did get it. We talked about a little bit about this one. On Microsoft, it wouldn't be the end of the world, but at 280, I think 255 makes a lot of people, 250 makes a lot of people go nuts. But that's the high of that day was 251 back on the 4th. So you've got some open up here. Not saying this is going to happen, just telling you right now that this pattern works very well. If we get the confirmation in the next few days, we You probably want to keep an eye on it and look at NVIDIA as the prototype. We'll be back in a minute with Isaiah and Starbucks.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Markets can rise and fall like the tides. Subscribe to Basil Chapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, and you too can ride the wave. Basil Chapman is an authority in technical analysis. His Chapman Wave trading system has been helping traders identify trends and capitalize on momentum in the markets since 1984. TFNN invites you to test Basil's proprietary Chapman Wave trading methodology with a monthly subscription to the Opening Call newsletter for only $149. Your subscription to the Opening Call comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, as well as daily market updates on key indexes, stocks, and commodities. Ride the wave! Sign up for the Opening Call risk-free today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And we're going to Isaiah in Virginia. How you doing, Isaiah? I don't know what his question is on Starbucks. Maybe if it sets up for this pattern. But if it does, basically looking at about 113, it's not one of the bigger ones out there. Maybe it'll just go fast there. So, you know, you had some decent volume down yesterday. You got about half that on the way upside today. But can you just kind of drift a little bit higher, kind of go with the mouse here? In fact, why don't we do this? Let's just go to what I can do here, which is, there we go. And we will drag this over here and draw on it a bit. Come on. I need my little tools. Share view, sidebar. There it is. Okay, and do that. Okay. So let's say you're here. You kind of think about doing this, going maybe up here, and then maybe something like this, and then you get that, right? So you close, you start your short at like 117 or something. And what happens there? You get 112, or maybe if you're lucky, 110. There's just a lot of them that are better. It's a pretty good warning signal, but you know what? That's kind of what you're looking for. You want these things to go down, go back above for a day, and sometimes they give it right up, but a lot of times they just go sideways for a couple of days. I'm suspecting that it pop up tomorrow, either give it up during that time, tomorrow afternoon, or maybe Friday. So that's kind of what we're looking for. In the meantime, sell when you can, not when you have to. And we'll see you here tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time. We'll be right back.